lie down in green pastures and leads me beside still waters. He revives my soul and guides me along right pathways for his name's sake. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You spread a table before me in the presence of those who trouble me. You have anointed my head with oil, and my cup is running over. Surely your goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
First readings from Acts. They devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and fellowship, to the breaking of bread and the prayers. All came upon everyone because of many wonders and signs were being done by the apostles. All who believed were together and had all things in common. They would sell their possessions and goods and distribute the proceeds to all as any had need. Day by day, as they spent much time together in the temple, they broke bread at home and ate their food with glad and generous hearts, praising God and having the good will of all the people. And day by day, the Lord added to their number those who were being saved. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Very truly I tell you, anyone who does not enter the sheepfold by the gate, but climbs in by another way, is a thief and a bandit. The one who enters by the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens the gate for him, and the sheep hear his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all his own, he goes ahead of them, and the sheep follow him because they know his voice. They will not follow a stranger, but they will run from that stranger because they do not know the voice of strangers. Jesus used this figure of speech with them, but they did not understand what he was saying to them. So again, Jesus said to them, "Very truly I tell you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who came before me are thieves and bandits, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters by me will be saved, and will come in and go out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I came that they may have life and have it abundantly." The Gospel of the Lord.
Are yours thy right, O Lord our God. whose Son, Jesus, is the good shepherd of your people. Grant that when we hear his voice, we may know him who calls us each by name and follow where he leads, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns one God forever and ever. Give us this day such blessing through our worship of you, that the week to come may be spent in your favor, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, you have made of one blood all the peoples of the earth, and sent your blessed Son to preach peace to those who are far off and to those who are near. Grant that people everywhere may seek after you and find you. Bring the nations into your fold. Pour out your Spirit upon all flesh, and hasten the coming of your kingdom through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Well, happy Good Shepherd Sunday, everybody. If you've been in the church for a while, you may know that this fourth Sunday of Easter is always the one where we turn our attention to the image of Jesus as the Good Shepherd. The gospel reading we just heard from John encapsulates this image perfectly, with Jesus likening himself to a protective gate for the sheep. This image of Jesus as the Good Shepherd is a really important one for us to keep in mind, especially at times like this. It's actually one of the church's oldest central images, and arguably, amazingly, even older than the image of the cross. The cross didn't really come into the central role that it occupies today until the 4th century, when Christianity went from being a marginalized underground religion to being the official religion of empire. And this transition was far more significant than initially meets the eye. It was not only a visual one, but a theological one. When the cross is the central image of our faith, it puts atonement at the center of our theology. The Son of God died on the cross for our sins. Now, this is absolutely a part, even an indispensable part, of the complex and rich theological tapestry that we call Christianity. But here's the key. It's only a part. When we make the cross the unique end-all and be-all of our faith, there's so much that we're missing. Our faith then boils down to something like this. We're all a bunch of miserable sinners who, left to our own devices, will sin our way straight to hell. But in the cross, God has provided a focal point where, if we're lucky enough to find it, some of us will avoid that horrible fate. I don't think it's going to come as a surprise to anyone that this is actually a caricature against which I often find myself in the position of defending Christianity in today's culture. And do you see the problem? With a theology Jesus, the Good Shepherd, as the central image of our faith. This image offers a theology that is perhaps much less clear-cut, but arguably much, much richer. Yes, a good shepherd does indeed protect the sheep from harm, but he also does so much more than that. individual and communal life we had before the pandemic than all we succeeded in doing during these months of quarantine is to avoid death. But what if we instead use this time to employ all of our creative powers to envision and move toward a new normal, one that has never before been? Then we have accomplished the pursuit of life. How might this new normal look? The sky is the limit. One of the most obvious possibilities is that we can decide we will do whatever it takes to ensure that there are no longer so many of us who are highly susceptible to contagion. We will have a long, hard look at what pathways led us to this point of compromised health and commit to following very different pathways going forward from this moment. Additionally, we might have a look at what gifts are really strong in us and choose to share them more broadly than we ever have before. I've been amazed over these past several weeks at the strength of the informal prayer and care networks within this church congregation that I had nothing to do with building and that probably have existed since long before I got here. Networks like this can really be the difference between resilience and despair, even between life and death, in the lives of those who are touched by them. Perhaps we can use our imaginations to make these networks more visible to the surrounding community and help them to broaden and touch even more souls. There are so many more possibilities for how we might use this as a moment to pursue life and the kingdom of God rather than merely avoid death. And my imagination is only one of billions. Where is your imagination? Inspired by Jesus, our Good Shepherd, inviting you to go.
Let us pray with joy to our risen Lord, saying, "Risen Lord, hear our prayer. O risen Christ, we stand in awe of your victory over death. Give to us the due reverence for the power of your resurrection, and use us as instruments for that power to be made manifest in all the world. Spread your resurrection power, especially today throughout the Anglican Communion, including Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury, and the Anglican Church in Japan, Nippon Sei Kokai. Pour out your Spirit also upon the Episcopal Church in this land and our diocese, including Michael, our presiding bishop, Mark, our bishop, and Good Shepherd Church in Berkeley. Let your blessing come also upon to our fellow faith assemblies in this community, especially Sunset Community Church. Risen Lord, hear our prayer. O God, in whom mercy and justice embrace, we ask for your love to take wings in all the nations and peoples world. Bend the hearts of all nations and peoples toward peace and righteousness. Send your Spirit especially upon Donald, our president, Gavin, our governor, John, our mayor, and all who serve in legislation. gathers together as a people made clean and whole by your grace, and desiring to know ever more deeply the power of your resurrection. Bless all its members with the gifts of hope, wisdom, and compassion. Pour out a special blessing on these members in our weekly cycle of prayer. Bernie and Dottie S., Dan and Peggy S., and Allison S. As well as those in military service, Aaron B., Joey E., Abigail M., Valerie M., Amber R., Christopher W., and Taylor W. Risen Lord, hear our prayer. We also pray for all who suffer in body, mind, or spirit, especially those who have requested our prayers for healing and wholeness. We pray for Abe, Alice, Olivia, Anna, Anna, Marie, Ashley, Audrey, Becky, Betty, Darian, Diana, Donna, Dorothy, Elda, Esteban, Glennis, Janice, Jason, Jebony, Jerry, Jessica, John, Joy, Justin, Kay, Marge, Marie, Marilyn, Mariana, Marianne, Mary Beth, Maureen, Naomi, Nina, Rachel, Robert, Sally, Sharon, Steve, Tina, Tom, and the Carney family. Give to your people the gifts of comfort and healing, as well as a life and abiding faith in your goodness throughout all circumstances. Risen Lord, hear our prayer. Lord Christ, in your passion and resurrection, you made death the gateway to new and eternal life. Pour that light upon all your servants departed this life, especially Frank, Mike,
Healer God, we come before you paralyzed by this COVID pandemic, paralyzed with fear for what tomorrow may bring, paralyzed with the social distancing from and the pain of our friends, our loved ones, and ourselves. God of action, help us to raise the roof over our heads. Raise the roof and let light shine through. Raise the roof and bring us closer to your presence. Raise the roof and let hope into the rooms of our hearts. God of love and compassion, we ask your forgiveness for our sins, sins of hopelessness and despair, sins of indifference and denial, sins of accusation and judgment, sins that overpower hope and faith and miracles. And miraculous God, help us to have faith in miracles, miracles that can wipe out this virus and stop the flow of tears, of anger, of blame, of judgment, miracles that restore our bodies, our souls, our spirits, our relationships, our faith, our finances, miracles that enable us to love, forgive, act, heal, live. Healing God, work mightily in our lives today, acting, loving, forgiving, making miracles, that healing and being healed, we may walk and be close again. Amen.
One accord to me.